Alright guys, this is Daragon from YouTube anyway. As you can see, this is Windows 8. So, a few people asked me to do, pretty much, a review of it, which pretty much is what I'm doing right now. So basically, this is the start screen. Right here is the email app where you check your email. I don't feel like showing this. This is the calendar app. It's pretty decent. You can mark it, and then it marks the day of what today's events are. The only thing I don't like about it is the fact that it will remind me if it's someone's birthday on Facebook, which I find really annoying, because I never say happy birthday to anyone on Facebook. So, yeah. And right here is the people app. I would show you it, but these are, like, people on my Facebook, so it will show the names. Messenger app, much like the same, except I never used it yet, so it's kind of pointless. Then here's the desktop. As you see, Cam Studios right here recording for me. Basically, it's Windows 7 without the start menu button. You're probably like, how do I search stuff? Well, to switch between like the start and stuff, you go up to the top right and then down. And then you could go to your start screen, or like, let's say I open, what will I go to next? Guess I'll go to the store app. So yeah, for me personally, this thing takes a while to start up, especially when you first, like, not when you first start it up, it takes forever. Like, these apps just take ridiculously long time just to start up, in my opinion, at least. Last time I recorded this, it came out pretty bad, and then it was revealing people's names. Try again. So anyway, yeah, as you can see, when I showed you it, it had a 2. So what the 2 meant is that there's probably 2 updates for the programs that I have, for the apps, I mean. So, see if it's true. Yep, 2 updates were available. Which, you click it and it'll show you the updates. It will probably update the thing in itself. And then it will have these dots, which means it's proceeding. Pending. Now, I guess I downloaded them really quick, or it automatically did it while I was in the background. And now it's installing it, so it's fairly quick. I've never used the connected photo thing yet, so it's a HP app, and not everybody has one. But as I showed you before, it will show the calendar, and then it will show the store. For some reason, the store doesn't want to load. I don't know why. It's kind of stupid. So let's force it to load. You can check your apps by right-clicking, and then it will show them off. Of course, Windows 8, I don't know why it takes a ridiculously long time. I had these installed at one point, but it's just not worth it. So, sort of name. Again, it takes pretty long time. I don't even use all these. I personally should install a finance. I don't know why I have that. The hell, I have that? An eBay app. I got Jetpack Joyride for this review. So. And you got smart glass, and you got photos, which, photos basically loads every photo you've saved to your computer, and then makes it in a shitty ass thing. Takes a really long time, in my opinion. See, as you can see, some of my photos, it's really slow when you first start it up, like I said. Photography, I guess hopefully this has nothing embarrassing. Well, this is my beautiful face, I have a lot of photos. Then right here, you got the news and I think weather. I might be wrong. This might just be news. Again, apps take a really long time to start up for some reason. Personally, I don't like the idea of apps. I'm still trying to get used to it, especially the Skype app. And as you can see, this one's just taking a while. Wish it would load quicker. I guess while it's in the background loading, I'll do this, so. Maps, I'm pretty positive, like Google Maps. Again, it might take a while, which is annoying. Yeah. Another neat feature, though, while it's loading, I might as well show you. Go to the top right and then go down, and you could click this. Start brings you to the start screen. Obviously, search, you can search anything. I'll be like, decent. Files, so you go to files, and DSIM will find a lot, because, that's my pictures, app settings, that's all this jazz. Another thing is devices. I have not hooked up nothing yet, so second screen, I guess, if I wanted another. Also, I like how it tells you the time in big letters when you do this. Then, I don't know, to manage, yep. Then you can check your wireless, you get out of your sound, your brightness. I like having it all the way up, notifications. Power, I guess you power it off from there, which I think I just learned just now. I know I've used this before. Keyboard, I think you just pick like the language you want. And then settings, you can personalize this. You know, I could choose any of these. I just pick a picture of myself because it's my computer. You can change your password, create pins, turn notifications on, search. You could, I don't use those personally. You could switch all this. Privacy, devices. I had to set up my printer soon. SDHC card. I guess, download over metered to prevent extra charges, keep off whatever device. You could do that. Ease of access. I want to mess with this. This basically turns the screen like mad ugly. Watch. Look how ugly that is. I will never use that high contrast mode. I don't know the point of it. I don't want to know the point of it. And sync your settings on, I don't know, home group. Change sharing. Oh, no. Windows update, you can check for updates. That's the part, that's why you need to know where the settings is to update stuff. Hopefully it's not another update, because I just updated it, and this thing takes forever to update. Like, I'm not even lying. Let me close a few, maybe it's because of this. Yeah, maps. But yeah, like I said, you know, I would allow my connection, but I guess it's pretty much just Google Maps. So I zoom in, since I live in New York, I might as well, let's see, zoom in. As you can see, you can check New York and stuff, zoom in, keep zooming in. I don't know if there's street view though. I might be wrong. I've never used this before, so don't mind me. Show traffic. Map style. Aerial view. There we go. So you can basically see the houses and stuff, you know. Which is cool. I think if you drag this, it goes to street view. No. Because it just twists and turns it, which I don't really want right now. Now, I don't know how to use this. No, not my location. I will not share that. But yeah, that's maps. SkyDrive, don't think I have anything personal on it. Basically, it's just, you upload something to it, and then share it, and you can access it on anything. This is an essay, this is Dead Man's Gun, the song from Red Dead Redemption. It's a really good song. Download it, check it out. And you can check the weather, which is cool. I live in Yonkers, so. Yeah, you know, has Yonkers. I don't know why these things take so long to load, personally. It's really annoying. But then it gives you the forecast. I don't know how accurate it is, so it's up to you if you want to trust it. Skype, I would show you, but I don't think my Skype friends want to be seen on here. So, trending is Bing, I guess. I guess you search stuff. I might uninstall that now that I think, because I never use Bing. Yep, I don't like this. So, if you like Bing, all for you. You can have it. I personally don't want it. Travel. I don't travel a lot, so I might uninstall this. This is like preset apps, and they just waste space, in my opinion. I'm not into this stuff, so probably uninstall this. Which, I mean, if you're into it, good for you. I think there's finance, which I don't use either. I guess it shows you stocks. If I was, like, rich and was into stocks. Not into sports. I mean, if you want to see sports, go ahead. But I'm more into WWE, and they don't consider that a real sport. So I doubt it's shown on here. So let's check it out, I guess, for you sports fans. These are, like, built-in apps. I don't know if this is every Windows 8, but you could probably get it on the Windows 8 store. But, yeah. This... It's just, I'm not into football. If you are, it's this could be good for you. It's basically like the Xbox interface. And then game is probably the coolest feature that I don't use for some reason, in my opinion. At least, you know. Basically, it signs into your Xbox profile, shows your achievements. So, what is this? This somebody might have messaged me. I don't know who this is, but I guess I'll accept him. James? I don't know who that is. He's from England, and he's dressed up as Batman. I don't think I want him. Mizmins, there's a shout out to you, I guess. You can customize your avatar, which is cool. Rockstar is my favorite. I got it from Red Dead Redemption, the t-shirt. So, I mean, it's probably my favorite. I always keep it because, personally, Rockstar is one of my favorite companies. Anyway, the bio, you get editor bio, which, I mean, it's cool, I guess. I don't really care that much. Your view achievement is really cool. It could be for either PC games or Xbox games, which I find really cool. You also could check out, you click a game, and then it gives you, like, extra details. And then you could check avatars, you can check gamer pictures, themes, game add-ons. So say I didn't own one of these. I think I own the Cerberus Network already. You could check it out and I guess buy it if you potentially add money on your account. You could check avatar items. Yeah. Which I guess is cool. Yeah. All for you if you're into that stuff. I don't personally buy avatar items. Never will, probably. So, yeah. You can check achievements for either games or Windows Live. Usually it takes fairly long to load up, like right here. As you see, it takes pretty long. Maybe it's probably my processor, or it's the fact I don't have a solid state drive. Then you look at other people's profile. King of the light skinned people. I guess it's supposed to be a funny joke or something, but alright. Then you can get games, like I said. I got Jetpack Joyride just to show you for this video. I think this costs money. Let's check. I ain't buying that shit. Yeah, but as you see, I'll show you Jetpack Joyride. It loads up game pretty much in the Windows 8 interface. I think it loads up, like I might be wrong. If not, I apologize. I'm not going to show you that much because personally, I don't care about this game. It's just like a cell phone game, but you know, on Windows. Which, I can't see anybody playing a game like this on their Windows computer. So, I mean, missions. Alright, I want to play. How do you begin? This is really loud as hell. But yeah, as you can see, Jetpack Joyride, yeah, great game, I guess. You get coins and stuff. I don't know the purpose. It's like one of those casual games, if you're into that. But I'm gonna die on purpose, cause I don't feel like playing. So there you go, that's Jetpack Joyride. Go to the home menu. How do I quit from here? I guess I gotta Xbox Live, really. But yeah, that's about it. And then you check your game activity where you last played. I think it's from down this order. Or it might be from down this order, it goes bottom, I mean top down, over and over. That's your. Then you can check games, like I said. I guess it shows you more games, you know, if you want. Shows Xbox games, that's about it, like recent games that came out. So, I'm pretty sure it's fairly old, that game. I don't know, that's on there. Max Payne. Might be in alphabetical order. All games. Yeah, so that's about it for this section of the review. So, now we'll move into camera. You know, you can just see my beautiful face. Camera options, I don't know why it's that low resolution. But yeah, as you can see, I get widescreen. You can see my beautiful messy face. I haven't showed my face in a while in a video where I either take it down or put it on private. So yeah. You could also take pictures. Gives a countdown as you see. I'll be like. Oh, there's a video. So yeah, it's a video. Video mode would be white if you had it, or you'd be like, yeah, it's a picture. And then it adds it to wherever the hell it goes. You could go through your old photos and stuff. So that's that. I don't really download videos, but there's the music. I would play music, but I would get a copyright strike, so I'm not gonna do that. So I'll avoid my copyright strike because I don't want a copyright strike for no apparent reason. I find that pretty stupid to kind of a copyright strike. But you know, like I said, this app takes forever to load, so let's wait for it to load. Top music, I guess, like recently, Adelaide, Recovery, Parental. I'm pretty sure it's pretty old stuff. Minutes, it's really old stuff, some minutes. But then you can have your music, go here. You can look by artists, so yeah. I ain't gonna play anything because I don't want to get a copyright strike. What, I don't know what a smart DJ is, but hopefully just don't play music. I'm gonna have to prepare myself. Hopefully that person who's coming is not here to distract me. And any day, I don't know what this is, so it's gonna be new to me and you. I don't even know if it's worth the wait, to be honest. Any day now. Yeah, well, I guess, we ain't gonna figure this out, because I don't feel like waiting that long for it. It sounds stupid anyway. Video is just basic video stuff, you know, and it's not really, you know, spectacular. I got Netflix. I've never used this personally myself. eBay, I would like to see this real quick. I don't use eBay, nor do I intend to, because I don't like the idea of bidding on stuff, even though you search by. Except, you know, because we all read the terms of use, let's just accept this. I don't know why. I guess I have to scroll down to accept it. Watching, finding, search. So let me see. We use, since that's gonna come out soon. Yep, see? I guess if you wanted a bid on something, you'd place a bid. I don't know why people would pay that much for it. It just came out the other day. Well, tomorrow or today, I forgot. Yeah, Microsoft, Mahjong, I don't play any of this stuff. You know, then it shows you games you installed. So say I want it, like, where's desktop? Oh, somebody texted me. Watch that, give me a copyright strike just because it's Mario. I guess I can't have that many open. Anyway, say I want, this. I guess I'll pin this terrible cell portrait. I can't pin that to start, so. Pin Microsoft Office Download Manager to start, and wherever it is, it would be located somewhere here, right there. So yeah, I actually gotta remove some of these. Unpin. I don't want this, Jesus. So, as you can see, I already did it for like Steam. So it would load Steam up, you know, and I'd see deals right away. You know, nothing particularly good has come out that I want. You know, so I won't buy nothing. I did buy this terrible game. Well, it's not terrible. It's just not my type of game. Hero Academy. Just for Team Fortress items, right? Let me show you. On a side note. Hero Academy. Alright, let's just go to the gold pack. I bought the gold pack. I guess I regret doing that. Team Fortress 2. Okay guys, before I was brutally interrupted, like I said, I bought this for the Team Fortress hats. I really wanted this and the tribal, and I was like, why not? I'll buy everything because I get this download content free with it. So I was like, I figured I'd take a part of the deal. I got distracted, like I said, so yeah, I was interrupted. But yeah, for some reason, the items don't appear on my Team Fortress 2. I would show you it, but yeah, it's besides the point. So, what else is there to show you? Windows 7, when you have, a touchpad, like say you have a laptop and you swipe from the left before your mouse trackpad, you could switch it like that. I don't know how to do it with the mouse yet, but you could do that and to scroll with it. You gotta have two fingers on your thing, and it's really inaccurate, which I find annoying. One thing I didn't figure out how to do yet is actually zoom out with the mouse. Basically, you would go like that, and it would zoom out, but for some reason I can't do that on a mouse. I've yet to figure it, but if I do find out, I'll let you know. I think it is possible to do it. You just zoom out like that. It's pretty cool. Somebody else, I don't know how to slide like stuff like that. It's really annoying in my opinion. So, yeah. Just personally me. That's about it for this review. It's close to the end. What else does Windows 8 have that nothing else does? I mean, can't figure anything out right now. This is the end of the video. Seems pretty good so far. I don't know if logging out will mess it up. I don't know what AskMet is either, so if you know what it is, let me know. But yeah, you could put basically anything on here. Kindle, I guess you could put books on here. So if you're a reader, you know, that actually loaded really quick for some reason. Unlike everything else, yeah, that's just about it. If you want to know anything I missed out or you heard about, just let me know. Comment, subscribe, like, I don't know, do all that stuff. It helps the channel. If the mind isn't that great, hopefully I never get interrupted again, which is helpful. But yeah, it's me, Daragon. And let me do this the proper way. Deuces.